Good morning. I'm Ansley Ertle with the Alpine Group. As I've gotten to visit with a lot of you this week, I hope you've had a good week so far. Today, obviously, is the big day for us as the local DC people. We love having the opportunity to get you up on the hill and show the members of Congress, the businesses, the actual people that go with the businesses that we're talking about on a daily basis. So Rob asked me to go over a few housekeeping things. There's going to be a group photo at 8:50 this morning just outside of this room near ACA's registration desk. So if you'll go there from here, then head up to the lobby to board the buses that'll be leaving promptly at 9 a.m. They'll drop off at Garfield Circle for those with house meetings, and then the Senate buildings are within walking distance. And today's transportation is sponsored by Adara Technologies. While on the Hill, please take advantage of ACA's lobbying lounge. It's in B338. The B is for basement. So you'll be going down, most likely, of the Rayburn House office building. And they'll have that set up from 9 until 2. You can relax and enjoy refreshments at the lounge. And lunch will be served from 11:30 until 1:30, sponsored by BBC American and Adara Technologies. Once your appointments are completed, the best way back to the hotel is just to catch a cab. They're very easy to grab on the Hill. There's also a metro. On the House side, there's the Capitol South stop, and on the Senate side, you can go to Union Station. Tonight, beginning at 7:30, our closing dinner and reception will be held in the Grand Slam restaurant here in the Grand Hyatt Hotel. And the sponsors of that are CommScope, Up Aspire, National Information Solutions Cooperative, and Olympusat. I'm sure I butchered all of those. So this morning we have the privilege of having Ryan Walker from Congressman Bob Latta's office. Congressman Latta is the representative from Ohio's 5th District. And he is also the vice chairman of the House Energy and Commerce Telecommunications Subcommittee and the co-chair and one of the founding members of the Rural Telecom Working Group, which is very important for all of you and your issues. And most importantly, he's been a friend to ACA and has spent a long time and put up with us a lot. And really more so Ryan than his boss is stuck dealing with us more often. Ryan has been serving the district, this district for 12 years. Before he was with Congressman Latta, he was a legislative director for Representative Gilmore and has been the chief of staff for Congressman Latta for the past 6 years. And he's been doing tech and telecom issues for 10 years. And I have known him, we have known each other for our entire lives in D.C. So with that, he's going to give you a little bit. He worked tirelessly on getting the set-top box integration ban included in the Stella draft that we talked about yesterday. So he's going to touch a little bit on that, and then we'll send you on your way to the Hill. So with that, let's give a welcome to Ryan Walker.
Morning, everybody. And it's great to be here with you today. I do send the regrets of my boss, Congressman Latta. As Ansley mentioned, he's one of the co-founders of the Rural Telecom Working Group, and he's actually, the Rural Telecom Working Group is actually meeting this morning with Chairman Wheeler. So he is unfortunately unable to be here and sends his regards. But before I talk a little bit about the set-top box integration ban issue that we worked really hard on, I just want to reconfirm probably what you already know in the fact that with Matt Polka and Ross Lieberman and the Alpine Group, you have the most professional and the best advocates you can have working on your behalf each day on Capitol Hill. And I've had the pleasure of working with them all for many years, and it's been a great experience. But you know, there's with the integration ban, I was mentioning this to my boss the other day, There's few times in politics or in public policy when you can actually truly celebrate a win that's good for citizens and good for consumers. And if getting the integration ban in the Stella reauthorization is that, I mean, it would make the ESPN top 10. It, it's just, it's one of those moments in politics and public policy where, like in professional sports, they have sometimes on a daily basis in their games, this is one of those high five moments. This is an area where the FCC went beyond congressional intent. My boss saw the need, and often likes to remove burdensome regulation. And the integration ban is that, and costing consumers and industry over $1 billion since 2007. We were able to garner some support from Ranking Member Waxman in terms of the energy efficiency problems that the cable card creates in set-top boxes. And in addition to that, the cable card regime never really materialized, as I'm sure you all know. It actually created a market outside of itself with Roku and Apple TV, and now with Amazon launching Fire TV yesterday. So this is, you know, at approximately $56 a box, that's real money to consumers and citizens. And, you know, this is going to offer the opportunity for you all to drive that money back into innovation. And I think those are compelling stories to tell as you go out onto the Hill today, as you meet with members of Congress and staff. And you know, I was asked to kind of give a staffer's perspective as you go up on the Hill today. The first and probably most important thing that I would say is be flexible. If there are, you know, I'm sure there are votes today and the schedules will vary. So if their times get shuffled, I would caution you to not get very frustrated. I'm sure some frustration will set in. But I know, and I can speak for our office and many other offices as well, that we do our best to see constituents and manage the time, both his time in committee, his time that's necessary to be over on the floor voting, and getting the necessary administrative things done in the office. But seeing constituents is our top priority. I know that Buckeye Cable, that we've met with Alan and you folks many times, and it's a pleasure to do that. And each one of you to go in to your members of Congress to tell them the story of why such a policy of removing the integration ban is important to your business, is important to consumers. Because it's not, while you need and value the professionals here in DC on a daily basis, it's your stories from back in the district, it's your stories as a job creator that are important to each and every member of Congress. And this is real money that the integration ban will save, and real money that can drive you know, back into creating jobs, to creating innovation, to creating a better consumer experience. And that's something that, you know, that we value with our constituents, is a good customer service relationship. And I'm sure you all can value that. And I think every congressional office values that. Going up to the Hill is, there's nothing more important than having you all here today and being here for ACA Summit. You know, as I said, you have some of the best professionals working for you on a daily basis. And if there's anything that our office can do besides what we're already doing with integration ban and working with the committee on the JSA language that was in the Stella reauthorization, we're happy to sit down with anyone and to discuss anything. And especially, you don't have to be from our district. We're here to listen to anyone. And that's going to be very important as we enter the process of the Communications Act update that Chairman Walden and Chairman Upton have announced. So with that, I thank you for having me here today. Thank you for supporting Congressman Latta. Thank you for evangelizing our integration ban bill. It's been bipartisan, and it's good public policy. So thank you all for your efforts.
I just want to say, there are no finer people that you'll work with on Capitol Hill than a guy like Ryan. He is someone who, as Rod has said, gets an issue and really knows how to work an issue on the Hill with his boss, Congressman Latta, who's a terrific friend. So thank you for your hard work, your dedication, your time with our members. I mean, you're exactly the perfect guy on Capitol Hill, and we love working with you. So thanks for being here this morning, Brian. Thanks a lot. Appreciate it.